In this video, we will learn about the importance of restocking inventory and how to use the tool to manage your inventory. Keeping your stock at the right level is critical for your success as an Amazon seller. It reduces the number of lost sales due to being out of stock, it helps you maintain your sales rank, and you minimize your excess inventory from the start by sending in the right level of stock. There are three main items to help you put together a great plan. 1. Understand your Amazon year and know when your peaks are. This could be Prime Day, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, and Christmas. Or, depending on the product you're selling, your peaks may be different if you're selling back-to-school products, summer clothing, or Christmas ornaments. 2. Know your lead times and reduce them. Lead time is the time it takes you to complete your restocking process, from identifying when you need to restock until the inventory is received at the Amazon Fulfillment Center. You should work with your supplier and manufacturers to reduce your lead times. And 3, develop a process for minimizing effort in managing your restocking. To save time, you can take actions in bulk, manage by exception, and automate where possible. Amazon provides a restock inventory tool to help you understand when and how much inventory to replenish. Its benefits are auto-calculated recommended order dates that factor in your lead times, recommended order quantities that account for seasonal demand patterns, and it is adjusted for past sales and is based on your inventory constraints. To get to the Restock Inventory tool from Amazon Seller Central, click on Inventory in the top menu and then select View Inventory Dashboard. Within the dashboard, select the Restock Inventory tab at the top to open the tool. The Restock Inventory tool is customizable. Start by setting your desired preferences. Here, you set up key defaults for lead time, which is the number of weeks it takes to receive the product from the supplier, and the reorder frequency, which is the desired number of weeks between orders. Once those are saved, it returns to the Restock Inventory main page where the information can be sorted by using filters. Filters allow you to customize the view and find information quickly. Here, the data is sorted by recommended order date, then by sales. It can also be sorted by sales, high to low for the past 30 days. Another key field is days of supply, which indicates how many days until the inventory runs out on a specific item. To see additional recommendation details on an item, like SKU, click on View Details. On the SKU Details page, you can adjust parameters to fine-tune the restock recommendation results. This includes setting your restock settings for supplier information and profitability. In the Restock Settings area, you can adjust the reorder frequency, the case pack, and the minimum order quantity. In the profitability area, you can adjust the cost of purchase amount. The results are viewed in the recommendations summary area. Once the seller's recommendations have been adjusted, return to the Restock Inventory main page to learn about additional actions you can take. By clicking the arrows on View Details for a specific order, it opens a drop-down menu where you can take action to create shipments and hide recommendations for non-replenishable products. Congratulations! You have now learned how to manage your restock inventory better and the various functions of the Restock Inventory tool. To learn more, watch the other videos in the Fulfillment by Amazon Inventory Planning series.